Hey guys, it's me again, Aspie Lauren from YouTube, Aspie Lauren's Autism channel. What is the goal of the video? To help people understand the importance of finding a good therapist if you're going to go the therapy route, and finding the right treatment plan for you, because not everybody can benefit from the same form of treatment. To enforce the most important and healthiest ways of dealing with autism spectrum disorder. What's the main goals of any form of therapy, whether it be the Sunrise program, additional talk therapy, or ABA therapy? First off and foremost, a person that listens to you and gets to know each person as an individual. Maximizing the person's good qualities and encouraging them to work on their weaknesses. Encouraging good health habits. To teach independent living skills without pushing them to be into what society considers normal. A good example would be if you got an autistic daughter that's still playing with Barbie dolls at an age when most girls would be into everything. I would say treat her just like you would any other child, but do it on terms that's realistic for her. So like, do make her do her chores every day and make sure she gets her homework done to keep her grades up, because I believe that doing chores is important to learning independence. But what you should do, as long as she gets her chores done and she gets her homework done, do allow her to play with Barbie dolls in her spare time. And the same goes for boys that like things that typical boys like at a certain age but don't like at a their age. Because I feel like that's the best way to integrate autistic kids into society. Because if you're like pushing them into it and pulling your daughter's dollhouse away, like once she gets to high school, because she thinks she's too big to play with it in her spare time, that's not going to work. What you should do is allow it, because when you're allowing them to be themselves and play with dolls at an age when most people have outgrown it, that's much healthier for them, and they're definitely more likely to conform to what society says is normal. Another example would be in terms of education and employment. What is a major no-no? Don't push the person to conform to the ways that are not normal for them. Just as in I said in the previous example. And in terms of looking for a job or dealing with stuff at school, what should your kid do? And what should the teachers and the bosses do? They need to get to know the person well. Keep in contact with the person's family and the therapist on a regular basis. Whether they have meltdowns or not out in public, some kids are embarrassed to talk. Some kids and adults are not as open as I am about things. We need to learn how to deal with that part and figure out ways to deal with the people that are open about it. I do think that therapy need to keep in contact with your family and your bosses, but when you do want to keep in contact with them, what you need to do is just do private outside or something, do FaceTime with them, and or send them private messages through Messenger on Facebook or emails or just a private message. And for the client, and for, I would encourage the same thing. And case in the way of employment and school, definitely need to find accommodations and allow them to have meltdowns. And if needed, find a private place to do it. Like, at times I've even gone in the bathroom stall and done it. Like, go out to their car and allow them to take as much time as they need to stem. Or go find somewhere to hide, but don't punish them for it. Punishment for stemming is not going to work. You need to punish somebody. Punish them for their attitude, not for meltdowns, because that is part of autism. And say this, what therapists and everybody else need to implement on the autism community is that maturity is not what is considered necessarily socially acceptable on the outside, but It's all about what's on the inside. Because if they're doing their best, but they're still having meltdowns and they get frustrated easy, then we need to step up and provide accommodations. Once we get to know them, they have many blessings that a normal person wouldn't have. Okay, once again, what do we need to look for in a therapist? That is one of the main topics in today's lesson. Definitely someone who listens without judging and takes their time and gets to know the patient and their family. And definitely number two, someone who is well trained in ASD and comorbid disorders and knows when to look for other illnesses and is willing to look for other illnesses, whether asked to or not. And definitely does not discriminate based on disability and provides treatment based on each person's individual goals. And number four, does not discriminate against the person's ability to pay or their family's ability to pay. And for somebody that doesn't have insurance or has limited income, they need to be willing to refer them to the appropriate resources. And I'm going to say this again, as I did in the previous video. For people on the spectrum, you're going to need to have an emergency fund available. For people that are more severely affected than what I am, you're going to need to pay for some stuff out of pocket once in a while. And a good resource that I have available for that is this lady. I watch her videos all the time. She's a really good Christian-based financial person. Three children, and they're all boys, and one of them has something called sensory processing disorder, and that's pretty common among people with autism. And her name is Lydia Sin, and I will provide a link to her videos in this video below. Money management very briefly in one of my other videos, but I won't have anything intense on it like Lydia Sin does. Let me say something about the basics about therapy. There's the traditional therapy, which is good for managing your thoughts and helping to talk things through when you're upset. And then there's the ABA therapy, which teaches people things and how to manage their symptoms and how to be more independent. It doesn't always get at the benefits of autism spectrum disorder. And then again, it's really expensive, even though insurances do sometimes cover it, and then some insurances don't cover ABA therapy. The other type of therapy that is good for autism therapy is something called the Sunrise Program, and it was not developed by others. It was developed by David and Samaria Kaufman for their son Ron, who was diagnosed with autism back in the 1970s, and they took him to every doctor in the world and could not find, and they weren't satisfied with the treatment options they were given. But, you know, kind of like me, their treatment options were limited. Even though Ron was born in the early 70s and I was in 1981. The Sunrise was started, I think it was around the mid 70s. And they integrated themselves into Ron's life. And a lot of work. Eventually, Ron was able to overcome his autism because of his family finding ways to enter his world. And if you want to know more about the Sunrise Program, I would encourage you to look it up and watch the movie on the Sunrise. It's all based on Ron's life. And the movie shows exactly how the Sunrise Program has played out. What's the con about the Sunrise Program? It's probably not going to be covered by insurance. But it's probably cheaper than the ABA therapy. Just like anything else, it's not medically approved. But people that use the Sunrise therapy say it really works. My cousin's wife works with kids on the spectrum, and she uses the Sunrise therapy on her patients versus traditional ABA therapy. Okay. From a Christian perspective, you know, the Bible tells us that we need to be willing to help other people. And I believe that before you can help other people, you really need to learn how to listen to them and get into their world somehow and figure out what they're like as a person, and then get to know them and figure out how you can to get to understand them better. I feel like the Sunrise is the way to go for a lot of forms of autism. They're able to be a little bit more normal, then I would recommend using the Sunrise with the ABA. But then again, I'm going to say that not every treatment works for everyone, and you need to be willing to find one that works for you. Just keep pushing and keep pushing. I would at least give it 2 to 3 months. You're not going to know in a week of trying a therapy whether it's going to work or not for you. And the same goes with medication. This is the end of this video, and I hope I've provided some good information. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And why am I wearing the same outfits that I'm wearing in my previous two videos? Shot them all on the same day because I'm trying to catch up on shooting my videos. Thank you. Bye.